what happens after we die, how to avoid the life review trap that causes us to want to reincarnate. It's a real mind fuck. It's real clever how the dark forces are setting things up. So after we die, we end up reviewing our lives and feeling bad about ourselves, and we end up wanting to come back and give it another go to fix it one last time, right? But we've been told this story more than once. Oh, it's just one last time. But they also wipe our mind and our memory, so we can't remember the last time they said only one more time. Can you imagine some motherfucker telling you, you only got to do this one more time, this shitty thing you got to fucking do, we got one more shitty job for you. It's like these movies where you got these assassins that are trying to retire from the fucking game, and the bad boss says, okay, you just got to do one more. And they go, oh, fuck. And he's pressured into it. He's manipulated into doing the one last job, and he's trying to change his life around. That's kind of like what we're doing here. One last time. Oh, okay. So we agree, and that's what they got to do. They got to get us to agree, but they have some very clever ways of getting us to agree to this shit. So we agree. So we come back one last time, and we get a mind wipe. That's part of the agreement. We get mind wiped because we trust these motherfuckers. We think these motherfuckers are angels, are guides, are loving beings of light, ascended masters, helping us grow and evolve spiritually. That is such fucking horseshit. That's crap. That's bull. But we go, oh, because we've been mind-fucked our whole last lifetime before we died and experienced these guys. And so we think we're talking to some really heavenly, wonderful, beautiful beings because they're radiating some light and they got on some nice robes and they might even got some fucking wings on and shit. Look, check me out, man. I'm a loving being. Hi, loved one. I'm here to help you. And yeah, these are motherfuckers. Okay? All right, so, yeah, one last time. So you get mind wiped and you go in for your one last time and you get have no clue of ever agreeing to one last time. You have no clue what they did to get you to agree. It's all a blank. You have to start all over from scratch. You don't even know a language. You can't even talk. Okay, you start over in a little baby body and it's all over again. But every time you grow up in any society or culture, you're going to get programmed into limiting beliefs about yourself, about consciousness, about life, and about reality. Okay? So, and you, if you got that inner desire to know the truth and you go, something's fucked up around here, something's fishy around here, then yeah, that's what you're doing right now. You're trying to figure it out, listening to bullshit like this and everything else you got on YouTube and the internet. And you're going, oh my God, this is fucked up and confusing. What the fuck is going on right here? So you're doing your best to sort it out and get your own story, your empowering story, that you feel is the one that's going to help enlighten you. And hopefully it's the goddamn truth. Okay? Good luck on that one. Really. Seriously. I've been going through that one myself. What is this stuff? That sounded good for a while, but then that mother saying this shit, and I go, I don't know about this. So cherry pick everything you hear. Just take the good shit. Never buy into one fucking teacher or philosophy all the way. I just say, don't do it. Don't do it. You know, it's just like, take what works for you. Create your own philosophy about how all shit works. And then go with that. So yeah, one last time, right? And then you drop dead this one last time. And you get back. You're not realizing they said one last time. And they do it to you again. We're hopelessly fucked, except if we start learning how they're doing it. So the next time you drop dead, you know what to expect. Watch out for the light. Don't go to the light. Your own light will shine, okay? But watch out for these loving beings that are waiting in the fucking wings. They're waiting for you to snap awake after your body dies. And they're going to be all over you like stink on shit. I'm sorry to say it, but they're going to be all over. Hi, we're here to help you. Hi, loving. You're going to go, what? What happened? What just happened? Your own inner light will start shining bright, and you will feel this wonderful glory. This is the latest story I've heard, and I like it. And I heard it by Cameron Day. Okay, check out his shit. AscensionHelp.com. No, Ascension.com. I don't know what the fuck it was. Anyway, I'm going, ooh, I like this story. I think I'll learn it and share the story and let people decide whether they like the story or not. But yeah, so you drop dead. you start leaving the planet. Oh, man. You start dropping off limiting beliefs left and right. Because, hey, I am a spiritual being. So anything that you had that you weren't, yay. If you thought you were going to go to hell and you're not, you're going, hey, and I'm not going to hell. Hey, this is cool. And you feel a little better. And then more limiting beliefs drop off. Oh, I'm not a needy, fucked up being. Oh, because look, I don't need food. I don't need shelter. I don't need rent. I don't need money. Oh my God. I am immortal. And just limiting beliefs starts falling off left and right. And the more that they fall off, the more shiny bright you become, the more connected you become with the great consciousness of all that is. Not this demiurge that created the physical universe, but the real McCoy, the ultimate supreme creative consciousness from which you are a spark and an aspect of. And you're going, whoa, I feel so good. And your light starts glowing and shining. And what I read is that these motherfuckers, these demiurge minions called the Archons, are right there pretending to be the beings of light, and they're the false light. And they are taking your feelings of connectedness and your light, bright shine of life, connectedness, and love, and all these wonderful things, and they reflect it back to you, your own loving light and connectedness feelings. They reflect it back to you with their fucking angel wings and their pretty faces and their pretty robes and shit. And they're making you believe that that light and that love is coming from them and God. And it's like they mind fuck you right there. And then they start flashing their own light at you. It's a dazzling light show. And it looks like the tunnel, you're going through the tunnel of light and you're going toward the light at the end of the tunnel. All this light show shit is fake and false. Don't fall for it. But they dazzle and confuse the being before he can get his shit straight, because he just fucking died anyway, and it's just starting to get really awesome. And now they grab you, but they look like the good guys. They look like the guardian angels, the archangels, the loving angels of love and religions, and you don't know what the fuck to think. It's like, what, huh, what? And they go, hi, we're here to help. And they're gonna haul you off. And it's literally like mind control, hypnotic programming. They're going to set your ass down, and they're going to pretend like they're there to help you. And the first thing we're going to do is review your life. You get to review your life and see what you think and how you feel about it. Oh, okay. Yeah. And they will flash you your shit. Every time you fucked up and you felt wrong, bad, or guilty, that's going to be in your face. Every loss, disappointment, bad thing or thought, they're going to flash. It's a setup. Where's the good stuff? No, they want you to feel really bad about yourself. So then they can tell you the story. Well, before they tell you the story about, well, you can go back and fix it. What they're going to do next is they're going to flash some past life imagery and experiences. And they're going to be horrendous, ugly, bad. Oh, like what a disgusting being you have been. Yeah. Guess what? Not your images. Not your past life memories. No, no, no. They find some disgusting sleazeball being who doesn't want to take ownership of his own bad acts. And they make you think it's your own transgressions. Your own moral decay. And you get to see it. And it's 3D, holographic, real, sensory, but you're trusting these lying motherfuckers, and you're going, oh yeah, and you don't even have an opportunity to say, hey, are you sure that's my memories? No, they're really sophisticated and fancy, and they've been doing this for gazillions of years, so they know what they're doing. And if they get you on this life review thing, and they get you looking at these past lives, and you agree that it was you agree that, oh yeah, I was bad, oh yeah, I was fucked up. The other guy that actually did those memories, whose memories they belong to, they're getting off scot-free. They don't have to reincarnate in this motherfucking matrix. But we do when we look and go, oh yeah, I was bad. And then they say to us, look, God loves you. That's fucking horseshit. You are the creator being that's important. You don't have to give your power away to some other archontic idea of a God outside of you. No, you are the being. You're the one, Neo. Okay? All right. So, if they can get you convinced that you were bad and all you have to do is go back one more time to get your redemption and live a better life, you agree. And they have you agreeing to all kinds of shit, including mind wipe. So then you get born into this world one more time because you agree to, because you get mind fucked. And so you start over. And the whole cycle starts over again. The intent is to never let you go. Okay? And you, like the movie, you are the battery. Your emotions is what they want. And they love the painful, stress, fear, all that stuff most. That's what they like. And so this universe of duality was created for all the negative shit. So every time you experience the negative stuff, emotionally, you are being harvested. So we are resources, we are the crops, we are the cattle, we're the sheep. We are food for these archons, okay? And one of their favorite physical universe life forms is reptilian. And the reptilian, as a life form, have as a subordinate group the greys. Okay? Now, what else is to know is that these beings, the minions of the corrupt demiurge creator being, his minions, or his, what you might call, avatars, you know, like in a computer game, avatars, the bodies, the vehicles, one of the preferred vehicles is the reptilian form. This is my understanding, I believe this. And then the lesser subordinate to the reptilians are some races of gray. Okay. So, what's to know, though, is that this operation of keeping humanity or keeping the beings here thinking we're human and reincarnating, it is a multi-dimensional mindfuck. It's not just physical. You know, like when you drop, your body drops dead, you're no longer in the physical universe. You're in the astral plane or whatever you want to call it. And we're never going to get a real good clear label on all these things, because there's the concepts and the philosophy and the understanding of the metaphysical world is absolutely full of differing subtle differences and opinions of what it's like out there. So we can't wrap our heads around a clear concept of what's true or not. So the mind fucking, the mental programming, also known as social engineering, is done multidimensionally. It's done throughout our life as we live, through television, education, authority figures, all kinds of ways, religion. But it's also done after we drop, our bodies drop dead and we're in the higher planes. We're still being manipulated, and we're being coerced or manipulated into, once again, coming back into the physical universe, material world. Okay? So, there's a way out. It's to learn how it works. You know, it's like learn how the labyrinth of the trap works, learn how the matrix works, so you can see its weak spots, or you can just stop doing what it's got you doing. Okay? So, when your beliefs change and you dig up enough of your subconscious beliefs, you tweak those, you release, let go of believing the bullshit, and you start knowing the truth, you start becoming more and more free and your vibration starts lifting up, and you can get out. You can get out in this lifetime, and what that means is you can leave this world one more time, this density, and you never have to come back. There's plenty other universes and reality systems that are not duality or are not corrupt. They're a joy to live and experience in. And you never have to come back here. Just knowing the sort of things I'm sharing. And if you don't buy every detail, that's okay. There's just so many variations and versions on this. The important thing is that you get a grip on the mechanics of how this is done so that you can do something yourself to change it, fix it. Okay? All right. That was my short little talk. Hope you liked it. Okay. Your comments are welcome. Apologize for no video. Still driving around the country in this beautiful universe. Yeah. Okay. Take it easy now. Comments welcome. Share your philosophies and your thoughts. You know, it'll help you to get it out of your head if you talk about it and write it down. You can write it down in a big, long comment or reply. And I read as many as I can. Okay, and write back as I can. Okay? All right. Take care. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.